Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I'm going to this instead of salt. The eighth generation of descendants here today of that original family that once again purchased this idyllic landscape once again from King Kamehameha III back in 1850. Now, the United States military actually came in here and acquired this land here after that fateful day, December 7, 1941, in which they actually built a well over 6,500-foot runway, which actually did run parallel here to Kamehameha Highway 2 as well. So that roadway also did intersect the likes of also that runway, and let's see, the United States military actually had to send out their Army Air Corps personnel to actually stop the vehicular traffic to allow aircraft to also take off and land. However, though, this air base was primarily utilized as a satellite airfield. There are no permanently here garrisoned here air crews, nor were there also here permanently assigned here aircraft to as well. This primarily supported the mission of Hickam Airfield, as well as Oak Bellows Airfield, and numerous other airfields around the island of Oahu too as well. Although there was a contingent of company of soldiers that were actually garrisoned here to protect Kualoa Army Airfield, as well as also to provide overwatch and part of here, also the self-defense network of the island of Oahu here during the war effort itself. We're obviously going to hopefully see with our own eyes today too as well on this here 90-minute tour. Hopefully 15 different bunkers, i.e. pillboxes too, left behind by the United States military. That first bunker over there to your right was actually associated to the likes of the air traffic control tower as well as the communication tower too as well. Although the United States military, after they handed back this land here to the John Morgan family, they actually removed a great deal of the military infrastructure, leaving behind though here these bunkers, i.e. pillboxes too as well. Now you also
thank you. to this project.